This video introduces the adjective πᾶσα, πᾶν, which you find in section 71 of Hansen and Quinn's Greek, an intensive course. That section is in Hansen and Quinn on page 217. πᾶσα, πᾶν is an adjective that you'll see all the time. Depending on how it's used in a sentence, it can mean all, every, or whole. It's an adjective, so we need to be able to decline it, to give it endings for it to be able to agree with any noun in any case, number, or gender. If I show you the nominative and genitive, you'll see that we have an adjective that declines in the third declension in the masculine and neuter, and the first declension, short alpha version, in the feminine. Pas, pasa, pan, pantas, pases, pantas. That means you know, once you see that genitive, how to decline the whole paradigm. So if we continue, in the dative we get panti, passe, panti. In the accusative, we get panta, passan, pan. And in the vocative, we get pas, pasa, pan. And you can see that that vocative is the same as the nominative. If you're learning your accents on adjectives, notice that the masculine and neuter, genitive and dative, shift the accent in the singular to the ultima, the last syllable. Otherwise, the accent is a persistent circumflex on the alpha of the first syllable when it can be. But sometimes it can't be, because the last syllable is long, and sometimes the circumflex has to change to an acute, because that alpha is short. You'll notice that every time that alpha is followed by a nu, it is short. Circumflexes can only appear over long vowel sounds, and so that's why it has to change to an acute in those words. Let's move on to the plural. Pantes, pasai, panta. Pantone, pason, pantone. You see the familiar exception to accent rules there in the feminine genitive plural. And then we get to the dam dative plural, which is trying to be this. But the consonants get squished and the alpha lengthens, and the word appears as passi with a new movable. Passais is the dative feminine plural, and the neuter dative plural is the same as the masculine. Accusative is pantas, pasas, panta. And the vocative is the same as the nominative, as is true for all nouns and adjectives in the plural. Pantes, pasai, panta. Again, apart from the feminine genitive plural, the accent is persistent here, trying to be a circumflex on the alpha of the first syllable, but turning into an acute if that alpha is short in these places. Again, you'll notice that's wherever the ad alpha is followed by a nu, or if the last syllable is long. Now, with any luck, all of this looks familiar apart from the accents, because this declension is exactly the same as the aorist participle active endings, which you've just been learning in your study of participles. Okay, using pas, pasa, pan is pretty easy. In predicate position, before the article of the noun it's modifying, it means all the, as in pantes hoi stratiotai, all the soldiers. Notice how that's exactly the way English uses all before the English article, all the soldiers. In attributive position, pas, pasa, pan means the whole, as in the whole country, he pasa hora. Again, that usage is just like English with whole, after the article, the whole country. Greek just uses the same word for both all and whole. In the singular, without an article, pas means every, as in pandoron, every gift. Pas, pasa, pan is an adjective you'll see all the time, and now you know how to use it any place you find it.